them. We are waiting for the final and decisive match, the mixed double. Mixed double is between a young combination from Malaysia, Hong Kong Ron, Cheah, up against a more experienced combination from Indonesia, Premier Jordan and Milati, Oktavianti. Here is Hupang Ron and Cheah making their way onto the court. We had a tournament back in 2017 together, but in reality we formed the partnership the year after in March in 2018 in Orléans Super 100, and we have so far three career titles, but that's one Super 100, that's a header back Super 100 in 2019, and then two international tournaments, so clearly not as experienced as their Indonesian opponents. Here is Praveen Jordan and Milanti Oktavianti. This year they were the runners-up of the Yonex Thailand Open, lost to Dutch Open and Sapsare in that tournament. Then at the Olympics they reached quarterfinal stage, lost to Zhang Zuwei and Huang Yacheng, but they were famous for winning the All England back in last year. When they won in Birmingham, defeating Dutch Open and Sapsare. First meeting, as you can see, between
I have black,
these two pairs.
Black. Oops.
Bert van Horenbeek.
That doesn't come. Okay. It is black. You serve? That side, who receives?
So the Indonesian selected to serve, and who and Cheah chose to start on the far side of the court. Jordan and Oktavianti played twice. Here in this tournament, won both of their matches. Yes, we have the profile of Hupang Ron from Kuala Lumpur, and he's in Bukit Kiara, also in KL. They're both 178 centimeters of height in the Malaysian pair, that's 5'10". And Hupang Ron is the brother of former international and women's doubles Vivian, who here is Cheah. She's from Butterworth in Penang, but of course lives in KL, where the national training center is. She's been as high as number 17 in the world with Chan Peng Son, now 27th, together with Wu Pang Ron. They lost against Watanabe and Higashino, but they beat Alison Smith in the match against England, and that secured Malaysia a 3-2 victory, and that they are here at all today. I mean, Jordan from East Kalimantan, and highest ranking with Debbie Santoso, second in the world, fourth with Oktavianti, the highest at the moment. Brian Jordan also won the All England with Davis Santoso as a partner back in 2016. Here you can see they won both their matches against Cheah and Nylon, the Cheah and Malon, the scratch Danish pair, and European champions Alimov and Dalietova. umpire from Hornbeck, and service judge that is a Russian Omi. Apart from Olinda, I won the Sea Games and French Open and Denmark Open back in 2019. And that means that they won quite a lot of consecutive matches in Europe. Denmark Open, French Open, All England 2020. And then two matches here, so that's 17 matches in all. They were not allowed to play in this year's All England due to the case with close contact on the flight from Indonesia to Birmingham.
So ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Malaysia, represented by Hu Panrong and Cheah Yisi. On my left, Indonesia, represented by Praveen Jordan, Belati Daiva, Oktavianti. Indonesia to serve. Praveen Jordan, Cheah Yisi, Lovell, Blake.
So I think there must be a lot of tension in this match here because Indonesia, in my opinion, came here with hopes for the title, at least. To get to the final, I think that was warranted, that hope. They have a strong team, in my opinion. Malaysia came here with a young team that was inexperienced, but have really fought well.
Serves over. One, two.
Of course. On paper, you would say that Jordan and Oktavianti are the favourites. I saw Hu and Cheah in that Toyota Thailand Open where they reached the semi-final against them. Lost to Seo and Che from Korea, but they beat Faisal and Jaya, the compatriots of Oktavianti and Jordan, and they also beat Shikel and Deray from France, who played really well in those two tournaments as well. So, I don't think we should rule them out, and I have an idea as well that Kevin Jordan can get really, really nervous in situations like this. If we take a look at the performances in the Olympics quarterfinal in 2020, Jiang Siwei and Huang Yachong also quarterfinal in 2016 with Debbie Susanto losing to Ahmad and Nasir. But then in the World Championships 2018 lost second round to Tang Chungman and Zhang Swet, who went on to win bronze, so they can definitely play. In 2019 lost second round to Peek and Tabling from the Netherlands, and they can also be a tricky combination to face. But I think that Praveen Jordan is very, very nervous now.
Service full court, too high. Serve 0-5, 2-5. Too high.
There's one thing that's really, really important for the Indonesians, and that is to get the initiative and control the rallies, play from above the tape, set up Praveen Jordan with his big smash, and then if something comes back, then it's up to Melati to take care of it. For the Malaysians, avoid the Indonesians to have the initiative in set situations. If they have the initiative, let Kevin Jordan move before he hits. Otherwise, put it below the tape, put the shuttle below the tape, and move Praveen Jordan and get Oktavianti out in the open with a number of flick serves so they can target her in the attack. That should be the two game plans that we're facing here. I would also expect, if it goes well for Hupong Run and JEC, that Hupong Run became quite a bit tensed if it looks like it's going their way. JEC a little bit more experienced, played a number of tournaments with Champion Song, the Olympic silver medalist from 2016. She did in 2017 when Go Lu Ying, Champions World's regular partner, was undergoing surgery and rehabilitation from the silver medal in Rio. They won the Russian Open together, Cheah and Champions World. Badly for the Malaysians, already in the service situation there when it was Melati land in the first two shots. Praveen Jordan, that's the overview of the situation. Very important for the Malaysians that they don't let the Indonesians slip away. If Jordan gets confidence, then he's perhaps the biggest shot maker in mixed double. Played the final match, Jordan and Oktavianti, against the Danes in the group stage tie, but Danes fielded a scratch pair and wasn't a decisive tie. Both pairs was going to progress. It was only a mild catastrophe if they were going to lose that match. Here they've fallen behind by 3 points as Hu Wenqie is 11-8 up.
Thank you.
Okay, Indonesian coaching on both sides of the net. Now we're the answer with the Jordan Oktavianti and Paulus. I hope I won the GMC. Oh, good save, good reaction by TGC. That's powerful. Launch yet, they're not done at all the last round relation mixed doubles pair, but the pairs above them are independent. The Badminton Association decided not to select independent players for this team championship. Simply, we're not certain about how much training they've been able to do during lockdown, where the national training center had been open. Independent players that participated in the Olympics also attended the training at the national training center until departure for Tokyo. Strapping on from Jordan's left knee. And whether it's just a precaution or it really is troubling him. Looks like giving everything in that backhand corner there. And as long as they can put it below the tape. Jordan has his key competences. 15, oh, and Cheah in the driver's seat. And we already know that the winner of this tie here will play Japan tomorrow in the semi-final of the World Team Championship for the Sudirman Cup.
11-15.
Chinese Taipei, 3-1. One left. she has herself, who come around, that's not too shabby either. Praise for enjoying the smash, but there's also some firepower in the...
16-12.
Who's... Oktavianti in the front court, but it has to be directly into the face, so to speak. They're playing well. Who wouldn't you?
Service over. 17-13.
Oh, that's great coverage. Amazing awareness by Cheah.
18-13.
Oh, instead of activate her, I'm going to play it soft in front of her. At the top of the tape. Hey, he saved it. In the end. Wasn't enough.
Serves over. 14-18.
Jordan bomb down the middle. Wait, that's a fantastic smash by Cheah. He gets a little help from playing with the drift, but good angle on it. Yeah. first one, which I thought was pretty good.
Serve Zerba.
Good there, GEC, but
17-19.
The second. Three game points for your opponents. Considered the most powerful smasher in the mixed double.
19-20.
I mean, Jordan. Cheah, they take the first set. Excellent service return from Cheah. You see,
21-19.
Malaysian have struck first here after 21 minutes of play. And the mixed double, 21-19. Info there from Powers to Hu and Cheah, and I'm curious to see how the start is, because I feel that it might have been too much to cope with. We just won the first game in the deciding match against a nation that you've never beaten in the World Team Championship. And you basically have the right plan. That's well played. We resist reinforcements.
1-4.
Now the smash from Jordan bites a little bit more, and with the drift,
it's 5-1.
More difficult to get the right length on any sort of defense from the Malaysian side.
Six one.
Malaysians, and they've created 5 mistakes themselves. Indonesia have scored 1 point, and that was a lift to the back court.
Serves over. 2-6.
Oktavianti.
7-2.
Two times playing it past JC and then eventually challenging her at the net. That's exactly what the doctor ordered. For the Indonesians, that is unreturnable.
8-2.
Big court area with the drift from Jordan in full effect. And there's hopes still for Indonesia. The net there, as Oktavianti had already moved out and away from the net. This was a bit what I feared would happen to the Malaysians after winning that first game. They've been totally out of the second here. And it can be because Jordan and Oktavianti, they have played really well, adjusted their tactics and so on, but I also think that Wu and Cheah look like they were totally confused. So 11-2 for Jordan and Oktavianti. And the mid-game interval in the second game, one game up for Human Cheer.
20 seconds. Thank you.
That's well played. The defensive shot that does it, and Melati is thrilled, his thumbs up.
12-2.
Gone for Hu and Cheah, and it's a balance between maintaining some self-confidence and some touch, and also not sort of showing your hand too much, showing what your plan is for the decider, especially for the decider when you change ends at 11. Very few rallies where Hu and Cheah has been in some kind of control in this second game here.
14-3.
Perfect play. Good services from Oktavianti. Very alert. Get the service a little bit past her, but still below take level. And it's totally disheartened.
16-3.
Quite nice. And you lost in your favor, and you lost the first game 21-19 to go up 16-3 in the second. The worst thing you can experience is opponents that sort of follow suit.
17-3.
Goes neck to neck all the way, and one game in the pocket. So both pairs here will have one game in the pocket. Oh, that's a good shot. On the backhand. Just the backhand, it's the amount of power it generates. He's a little behind the body, actually. There it is again. I think there's some local spectators here who's joined the Indonesian badminton party behind the court two here. That make it an enjoyable Friday night here in Helsinki. Wait, there's a big gap there.
Serves over. 4-19.
Team seeding. Consolation points here in the second game for Cheah and Hall. The Malaysians.
7-20.
A little outside of reach of Melati on the first one, and then in front of Praveen Jordan on the second. And should have initiative. Good point opportunities for the Indonesians and. A little bit of a show rally here. Lots of confusion on both sides of the net. As we're waiting for the third game. The second game to Jordan and Oktavianti in convincing fashion. If you only saw this game joined in between the first and the second, you would have wondered how on earth did the Malaysians win the first game. But they played much better, and the Indonesians were much more tense in the first game. So interesting to see what the decider brings. Thank you. love to
final game.
Have heard
Global.
Being able to understand what the Malaysian camp were discussing in the break. Lots of things going on. Let's see if they can change this match around. Again, they have the advantage playing with the drift here in the beginning of the third game. It's absolutely vital that they have a lead going into the change events here in the decider. The two Malaysians. Very important in the serve situation to be able to, within the first two touches, get the initiative. Well played by Jordan. Let's just look at the overall scoring time 2-2. So the winner of this game takes the tie and the semi-final berth. Lucky net court then for Praveen Jordan. So far they've done what's required. They've created a little cushion. The Malaysians. Chance of making Jordan nervous again. Getting some extra self-confidence. Didn't really commit to that. He was on the way back to the center of the court. At the same time he hit it, the loop on the right. recommended just to lift directly to Jordan on the service return. Played by Cheah.
Serves over. 8-5.
Excellent move. Comes from all across the court. On the tape again in the service return, but left.
6.
So you have to be a winner, just needs to drop below the tape. That's well played. Good actions by Oktavianti. And the Indonesians are closing in now.
7-8.
I would say at least 11-8 for the Malaysians. Not the change of ends to make it believable, otherwise I would say round it's Indonesia. That's amazing, and it's landed in, I think. Looked like he was going to go wide, but I think it stopped. It's a challenge by the Malaysians. It's a very, very important point decision. And they're right, the Malaysians. It was out. What an important decision to get there. Challenge. On the line, another decision that goes the Malaysian way. 10-7 up now.
10-7.
Who would have missed it had JC been able to get out of the way. Didn't go long on the back line. Fifth shot by Praveen Jordan.
9-10.
Very difficult to handle. gone wrong. I think advantage now with the Indonesians, no matter who leads by the change event. Point up here at 11-10 at the mid-game interval. But it's the Indonesians that go to the presumably better side of the court here in the Energy Arena in Banta. A lot of time and a little bit more.
11-10.
Well, it's been a fantastic quarterfinal so far, and now it's going to be decided. It's Malaysia or Indonesia who's going up against Japan in tomorrow's semi-final. She was quick in her reactions, but the back end. Good reactions. He's going wide. Oh, what a rally. It's going long. Amazing rally. They're satisfied here. The Malaysian supporters. Start to smell the sensation. Lucky net cord there. Maybe I should just say net cord at the service return there, because they practice going so sharp. Pushing the tempo over. Moving a lot back and forth there between right leg, left leg, throwing Jordan. Tension is creeping in. Good reaction.
Serve is over. 13-12.
Net court. And 3 points adrift now. The Malaysians
15-12.
Played really well since the change of ends and a little bit of luck as well. But they've been alert. Excellent. Go on the attack.
16-12.
Another lucky net called, and Jordan is not getting the big chances here. He was forced to hit whilst moving backwards.
17-12.
And Tina Mulalita on the head cheerleader there for the Malaysian squad. Going wide, oi, she takes it. Another one. What a rally, what a rally. And another win for Wu Penglong and Cheah.
18-12.
This is dire straits for Indonesia. Consecutive points, they were 13-12 up. The Malaysians now, I think it's decisive. It's not working today for Korean Jordan from below the tape. Can they all get the same game going as they did in the second? Two points away from history. And Tina is beginning to get away from the spectator's seat, not to trip over wires and stuff like that, because the Malaysians are going on court shortly. I think actually the referee should stop this, and he does. Girish Natsu, he says, off you go. First of eight match points saved by Oktavianti and Praveen Jordan. And here they are, the Malaysians. They are confident that they're going to play tomorrow at 4 o'clock. They're confident that they're going to get something around their neck. Ay, 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 ay. Big, big miss from Wu Pengrun. So far, he can afford it. halfway.
16-20.
To the goal, to the first goal for Jordan Oktavianti, serving 4 of 8 match points. There's a challenge. It's called in. And if the challenge is correct, and it in fact is long, then Malaysia are in the semi-finals. Let's see what Hawkeye says. It's out. Malaysia have done it. They've created history. They are in the semi-final of the World Team Championship, and for the first time ever, they have defeated Indonesia in a World Team Championship match. The World Team Championship tie, they've lost on two occasions in 1999 and 2011. But now they've created the, in my opinion, sensation, defeated Indonesia, who were amongst many's favorite in the beginning of the tournament. They were amongst mine. But Malaysia's young team here, they have really, really performed well. They get another chance to play Japan. They played them yesterday, and they're going to play them tomorrow again. She's in tears, Cheesy. Fantastic comeback by these two after they were totally gone in the second game. We're about to call them in the stadium speakers. Hu Pengrong and Cheesy, could you please come to court number two, because they were totally gone from that match. But what a comeback in the third game. Here is the decisive rally, that one that's gone long. And Tina Muralitharan first on court to congratulate her teammates. Excellent job they've done, the Malaysians. And sometimes you just have that little bit of luck that's needed. Again, the mixed doubles that delivered against England defeated Ellison Smith. They do it again, defeats Praveen Jordan and Melati Oktavianti in the decisive match. 21-19, 9-21, 21-16. So this is how it happened. The score, it started with Chien Seoul, the bronze medalist, defeating the world number ones convincingly in straight games. A hard-fought win for Gregoria Mishka Chunjung over Salvadora Kisuna in the women's single, and then another convincing win by Li Sijia, the All-England champion, who defeated the Olympic bronze medalist Anthony Ginting. Pauline Rahayu played a fantastic match against Tan and Tina, and eventually came out victorious after 91 minutes of play, 21-18 in the decider, and then this fantastic mixed double with the youngsters Hu and Cheah getting the better of the All England champions, the former All England champions, Jordan and Oktavianti. Here is the draw for the knockout stage, and we have the semi-finals tomorrow. China, Korea play in the early session, and Malaysia, Japan. A replay of the group match is played in the second session. So here is highlights from the match.